everyone, it's the Car Chick. And today on Shut Up and Drive, we're going to talk about passing zones. For those of you who just may not be aware, maybe you're new to driving, a passing zone is where on the yellow line between your lane and oncoming traffic, there is a dashed line, meaning you are allowed to cross over said dashed line and pass the person in front of you, presumably because they are going way too slow. Now, the people that create these passing zones and decide where a passing zone should be, they do it based entirely on safety. Not necessarily what you feel a passing zone should be, but based on what the speed limit is on that road and what the geographic landscape looks like. They want you to be able to have enough time at the speed limit, assuming you're not going to go over the speed limit, which granted most of us do when we pass someone. They want you to be able to have enough time to get around one car, not multiple cars, one car, safely and move back over without exceeding the speed limit. So that is how they decide how to create passing zones. And you need to be able to complete the pass safely and smoothly before that double dotted line ends. Once you get back to the solid line, you're not allowed to be on the other side of it. You're not allowed to cross it. You need to be back on your side of the road. So let's take, for example, this guy that was in front of me earlier. He waited to make a pass until the passing zone was almost over. And so, first of all, he passed two cars. It wasn't even safe for him to pass one car because he could not complete the pass before the dotted line or the passing zone ended. And the reason that it ended was because there was a rise in the road, which means you can't see over it to be able to tell if there is another car coming towards you. That is why they do not have passing zones in areas where there's elevation changes. You need to be able to see if there's oncoming traffic. And this guy could not see that there was oncoming traffic. So he made a very dangerous pass. And he made it worse by passing two cars in that area. And so by the time he completed the majority of his passing, he was over the double yellow line going up a hill where he couldn't see squat. So that was a really dumb and unsafe maneuver. And here's what's even dumber about it. If he had waited all of 90 freaking seconds, we would have been on this section where the highway merges into another highway that is two lanes on both sides, where he had all the time in the world to pass as many people as he wanted to his heart's content safely. But no, he was totally impatient and had to make the pass now. And you know, we were all going slightly over the speed limit, so it's not like the cars in front of him were going below the speed limit and just tooting along really slow. So there was really no reason for him to make that pass the way he did and when he did. So when you come across a passing zone, and if you feel the need to pass the person in front of you, granted, I do that a lot. I always feel the need to pass people. It's just the race car driver in me, and I have to exercise a lot of restraint, often unsuccessfully. But you need to make sure you're doing it safely and legally, because these passing zones, they're not just there all willy-nilly. They really put a lot of thought into what is safe. So folks, use your passing zones wisely and safely, because the goal is for all of us to get to where we're going in one piece. Thanks, folks. Drive safely. I'm out of here.